Good morning students, welcome to Narayana live classes. Today we are going to discuss about 8th class vectors assignment number 33. So let's see the questions. First question, linear momentum is A. So here we have to know two types of vectors. One is polar vector. So if we see the polar vector, the vectors which has translational effect, those are called polar vectors. Example, radius vector, displacement vector, velocity vector, acceleration vector, force, linear momentum, impulse, these are all polar vectors. And we are having one more type of vector, it is also called pseudo vector. And we are having examples. So the vector which is having rotational effect, it is called pseudo vector, or it is also called axial vector. We are having angular velocity, angular acceleration, torque, angular momentum. These are all the examples of pseudo vector. So here he is talking about linear momentum. So linear momentum is a polar vector. So that's why first option is correct. So let's see the second question. If A bar is a polar vector and B bar is a polar vector, then A cross B. So here we are multiplying two polar vectors with cross product. Two polar vectors with cross product. So if we take one example, torque tau bar is equal to R bar cross F bar. So here the radius vector is the polar vector, it is a polar vector, and force is also a polar vector. And if we do the cross product of two polar vectors, then we will get a pseudo vector. That's why the answer is pseudo vector. Third option is correct. Let's see the third question. The cross product of polar vector and pseudo vector is the cross product of polar vector and pseudo vector. So we will take one example, students. Here we know that V bar is equal to omega bar cross R bar. If we see angular velocity, it is a pseudo vector, and if you take R bar, it is polar vector. So here if you do the cross product of one pseudo vector and polar vector, we are getting a polar vector. So the cross product of pseudo vector and polar vector results a polar vector. So always results a polar vector. So that's why second option is correct. So let's see the next question. Multiplication of pseudo vector by any real number. So it is a scalar quantity. So when you multiply a scalar and a vector, always it results the same vector quantity. That's why when you multiply the pseudo vector by a real number, it aids is another pseudo vector only. So the answer is pseudo vector. Fourth option is correct. Thank you.